We're here at Derby Theatre and we're setting up for the Sigma 7 performance of Rosetta.
I'm John, I do the programming and play keyboards.
The inspiration for the show came from the European Space Agency's Rosetta satellite, which was launched 10 years ago. It's a bit of a technical challenge using state-of-the-art technology, digital audio over network. We're using a timax system to move sound around and position sound.
These are going to be fed as one.
It's perfect, yeah.
The guys in the band are a combination of some of my friends and some students from the University of Derby.
I'm Nigel Beer and I'm the trumpet flugel player, and I also play acoustic guitar on some of the tracks. I've been with Sigma 7 for the last 3 or 4 years now. Yeah, I'm looking forward to the show. It's quite a challenge, quite a lot to remember, but I think it'll go down great.
Hi, my name's Kay Morgrove. I'm a singer-songwriter. Stop doing that. I'm quite excited about the gig tomorrow. I'm a little bit nervous. I'm wondering how many people are going to be there, who's going to turn up, because I've heard that there's radio interest, magazine interest, so should be exciting, so I'm looking forward to it.
I'm Ethan, and I play guitar.
I'm Kieran, I play bass.
I'm Ben, and I play drums in Sigma 7.
It's been going really well, yeah. It's just been interesting to hear it like all coming together.
I've never played a surround sound concert before.
Never done it before, unfortunately, because I'm at the back, I'm not going to be able to hear all of it either.
There's some interesting challenges. The way we're monitoring on stage is a bit, you know, it's a little bit different.
Yeah. We'll need to have a cable that goes from wherever the Timex is, an XLR, just one single XLR, from wherever the Timex is, onto stage.
And the way the music is a combination of live performance and some programmed sounds. It's also great to have got the European Space Agency on board as well.
The evolution of the solar system.
I managed to interview a couple of the top guys involved in the project, and they agreed to let me use bits of the interview actually in the performance itself.
My name's Kit Lane. I'm the production manager and the video designer for Sigma 7.
Kit Lane has put together a video for each song in the performance.
It's surround sound music, so it's not like anything you've heard before. It's not even like 5.1 sound you get in cinema. It's all around you. And there's also lighting and there's large scale video projection.
Here at the Derby Theatre, it's a great space. It's got a lovely atmosphere. And we've got the expertise from colleagues at university and a lot of the students from the Sound and Light course as well. A great opportunity to take the audience to a different place.
Just really excited, I'm just ready to play now.
Voilà, on va écouter peut-être le lancement de cette dernière minute du compte à rebours. C'est fait ? Donc on va dire bonjour. À l'Agence spatiale européenne à Nordvik. À Darmstadt, à Frascati, à Paris. Et aux industriels associés au programme Ariane. Notamment au bureau à Bremen, à Vernon. À Zurich, sans malheureusement pouvoir tous les
citer. Ah, ils sont trop nombreux. Alors, bonjour aussi à eux. Tous ceux qui nous écoutent en Guyane, à Kourou, et puis bien évidemment à Ariane. Un
décollage d'Ariane nous laissant toujours un spectacle impressionnant. Nous allons donc nous taire, nous allons laisser les images parler d'elles-mêmes. Nous reviendrons dans une minute environ.
4,500 million years ago, a large cloud of dust and gas collapsed to form the sun. Around that proto-sun, a disk of debris was left. Early material, that primordial material, has been left there in deep freeze. To the evolution of the solar system. They are considered to be the remnants of solar system formation. There always is this challenge that mankind has to really understand where we came from. Of course, the origin of our planet. Help understand the origin of life very greatly if we knew how complex the molecules are that these comets also brought to Earth. When Earth originated, so some 4 billion years ago, they are considered to be the remnants of solar system formation. Comets are suspected as being the most likely candidates for bringing water to Earth. To the evolution of the solar system. Early material, that primordial material, has been left there in deep freeze. Over the period of the evolution of the solar system, there were periods of time where the inner solar system was just too hot to sustain water ice and water itself. Rosetta is going to provide us with really a giant leap forward in science. Thousand million years ago, a large cloud of dust and gas collapsed to form the sun. Around that proto-sun, a disk of debris was left. Within that debris disk, the planet started to form. The Earth to Rosetta distance is about 600 million kilometers. If we were sitting on the comet and looking back at Earth, you just wouldn't see it. It takes light 40 minutes to travel one way. Currently, we are slowly approaching the comet. Comet and our spacecraft Rosetta get close to one another. Never been done before. You have the possibility to have delivered building blocks for life.
That it went out. touch your face, reaching for your heart, reaching out to know you more. Reach across the years, reach around the stars, reach and touch your tears, reach until tomorrow. Touch the sky, reaching up forever, reach until we die. I'm calling out for you, I'm holding out for you, reaching out forever. Oh, superficial life, but I belong to life.